danger. Hi-yo, Silver! Away! A fiery horse with a speed of light, a cloud of dust, and a hearty hi-yo, Silver, the Lone Ranger. With his fearless Indian friend, Tonto, the daring and resourceful masked rider of the plains, led the fight for law and order in the early West. Return with us now to those thrilling days of yesteryear. From out of the past come the thundering hoofbeats of the great horse, Silver. The Lone Ranger rides again. Hi-yo, Silver!
If I were a tower of strength, I'd walk away. I'd look in your eyes, and here's what I'd say. I don't want you, I don't need you, I don't love you anymore. And I'd walk out the door. You'd be down on your knees, you'd be calling to me. But a tower of a strength is a something I'll never be. If I were a tower of strength, I'd watch you cry, I'd laugh at your tears, and tell you goodbye. I don't want you, I don't need you, I don't love you anymore. And I'd walk out the door. You'd be down on your knees, you'd be calling to me.
This is the visitor center for Washington, Arkansas. The entire community has been fully restored and rebuilt. Washington, Arkansas became the Confederate capital for the state of Arkansas in 1863 with the impending defeat and takeover of Hot Springs, Arkansas. So the entire government shifted for the state down here. These buildings were in disrepair. Several years ago, they were completely restored, and there's working exhibits throughout many of the buildings. Very interesting. The railroad was bypassed, the railroads bypassed this town, and as a result, Hope, Arkansas got all the commerce and highways. Of course, that's the birthplace of President Clinton, Bill Clinton. I walked over to the print office, which has a remarkable collection of machinery that is still in working order. As with all of the buildings, there's
Hi.
A docent.
Good morning.
How are you doing, sir?
Good.
So welcome to the print shop. My name is Brian. I'll be your tour guide here for today.
Okay, thank you.
As you can see, we have at least 140 years of printing history in this building.
Wow.
This right here is a 1845 Washington press that was found in Barbersport, Arkansas, also known as the Crater of Diamonds.
This building is the county courthouse, which for many years during the Civil War and afterward served as the main circuit court for this area. Inside there's a docent, and she'll talk your arm off, but very interesting. All the wood in the ceilings and throughout the building are southern pine.
So it was a pretty big deal to get county seat.
Okay.
And then stay.
Thank you. tried to stomp on him instead of the other way around. But he had timing. A ticka, 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 good timing. A taka, 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 timing is a thing. It's true. Good timing brought me to you. Who in the world would have ever known what Columbus could do? If Queen Isabella had hawked her jewels in 1492, but she had timing. A ticka, 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 good timing. A taka, 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 timing is a thing. It's true, good timing brought me to you. What would have happened if you and I hadn't just happened to meet? We might have spent the rest of our lives walking down Misery Street, but we had timing. A ticka, 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 good timing. A taka, 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 timing is a thing. It's true, good timing brought me to you. Yeah, we had timing. Whoa, 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 good timing. Yeah, 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 timing is a thing. It's true, good timing brought me to you. Yeah, we had timing.
Hey, I'm Kathy Ernst, and
You graduated? What did you do?
I graduated in 1965 from Menlo-Atherton High School in Menlo Park, and I went on to college right after that at San Jose State. I majored in English and minored in U.S. History, got my teaching credential, and taught sixth grade for 5 years in the Alum Rock School District.
That's a tough district, isn't it?
It's a very tough district, mainly because there's a majority of minority students. Most of the students are the children of immigrants, and English is not their first language. So it's very difficult to teach a child to read when they can't speak the language. I had 35 kids in my class, and the ones that were performing the best were reading at a fourth grade level in the sixth grade. So I had a bit of a challenge in that regard, and also there were 35 kids in the class, so discipline was always an issue, which I did manage to conquer. I didn't learn the techniques at San Jose State, but I kind of made it up as I went along.
They probably appreciated you more than just a lenient teacher.
Yes, I was very structured, and I had an incident where a substitute teacher had a hard time with my class, and when I came back, I berated the students for their poor behavior, and one of the kids, not one of the kids that are trying to kiss up to the teacher, but one of the kids said, "But Mrs. Joy, when we misbehave, you make us, you know, do the right thing." So I said, "Oh, you mean you like to be, you know, you like to have limits set and you know what you expected of you?" And he said, "Yeah." So, I mean, that was kind of an eye-opener that's what they were missing in their lives.
Structure.
Structure, yeah, and consistency.
Mm-hmm.
Structure and consistency. And then I started my family.
You married somebody we know?
Oh, yes. I married Richard Joy, who is also a member of our class. The MA from 1965. We were married in 1969, and in 1974, our first child, a daughter, was born. Her name is Antoinette Marie. She currently lives in Roseville. She too is a college graduate honor graduate from Sacramento State, with a degree in human resources. And my son, Aaron, was born in 1980. And he's an Eagle Scout and has a degree in finance and is a great help to me. I've had numerous medical problems over the years. In 1989, I was diagnosed with breast cancer. Then 2 years later, it had returned. I ended up with a mastectomy, of course, chemotherapy and radiation. And then I developed a cancerous lymph node in my neck. And again, that was removed, followed by chemotherapy and radiation. And then I developed colon cancer.
Mm.
another round of chemotherapy and radiation and surgery to remove the cancerous section. During this time, by this time, Richard and I had divorced, so I was a single mother raising two children and fighting cancer. So the chemotherapies always knocked me down for several days, but get up and go back to work again the following week.
Strong.
And I think my kids kept me alive because I was so focused on raising them and not that focused on my illness. I also had diabetes, which because of the distractions of the cancer difficulties, I kind of lost track of. And as a result of that, my kidneys failed. And in 4 to 5 years ago, I had a kidney transplant. And that's working splendidly. And most recently, I've had heart surgery. I had aortic stenosis, which was dealt with a removal of the mitral valve and replaced with an artificial valve and a pacemaker. And then I had to have repair surgery because the aortic valve sprung a leak. They did that with a new surgery tech. Kept me alive because I was so focused on raising them and not that focused on my illness. I also had diabetes, which because of the distractions of the cancer difficulties, I kind of lost track of. And as a result of that, my kidneys failed. And in 4 to 5 years ago, I had a kidney transplant. And that's working splendidly. And most recently, I've had heart surgery. I had aortic stenosis, which was dealt with a removal of the mitral valve and replaced with an artificial valve and a pacemaker. And then I had to have repair surgery because the aortic valve sprung a leak. They did that with a new surgery technique that I was the 21st person that Kaiser has used this procedure on. So it's sort of on the leading edge of medical science. I'm currently living in an adult housing situation, adult community. Kept me alive because I was so focused on raising them and not that focused on my illness. I also had diabetes, which because of the distractions of the cancer difficulties, I kind of lost track of. And as a result of that, my kidneys failed. And in 4 to 5 years ago, I had a kidney transplant. And that's working splendidly. And most recently, I've had heart surgery. I had aortic stenosis, which was dealt with a removal of the mitral valve and replaced with an artificial valve and a pacemaker. And then I had to have repair surgery because the aortic valve sprung a leak. They did that with a new surgery technique that I was the 21st person that Kaiser has used this procedure on. So it's sort of on the leading edge of medical science. I'm currently living in an adult housing situation, adult community.
Thank you.